How to make quick 3D mockups in Adobe Dimension. Hey guys, Kerry Hawkins here with another VectorMade.com tutorial. Today I'm going to be talking about Adobe Dimension and creating quick mockups for your clients. Now I have a few videos that are in Illustrator and they show you how to create some mockups using 3D models there. I've got one on a coffee cup and a wine bottle, and I'll leave links to those if you're interested in that. They're very popular videos of mine. But I've found recently, as I've been digging through some of my Creative Suite software programs that I don't use, that I really like Dimension. It's limited. It's not like as good as like a Cinema 4D or some of those full-blown 3D softwares are going to be. But when it comes to just like creating a quick mock-up for your client of what a product's going to look like in real space, it's great. Especially if you're going to use spot coating or something like that where you want to show the difference between matte and shiny surfaces. Anyway, let's just jump in and I'll show you exactly what I mean. So this is what it looks like. You probably have nothing here unless you've used it like I have in this last week. But click Create New, and that will bring up a whole bunch of assets, just starter assets. That's what this is. And it's going to have models, and you'll have some textures or materials, as it calls it in this program. Here's some lighting, environmental lighting. You've got images for backgrounds and such. So anyway, these are all included. Plus, you can go on to Adobe to get some more stuff. I even downloaded a few extras for free, and some of them are paid, but there's quite a few assets so far. What I'd like to do today is show you this beverage. So I'm just going to click on it. It will plop it down right here in the middle and have it selected for me. And there are, let's just go over some of these real quick. The important tools. I'm not going to go over everything today because there's quite a lot you can do in this program, but I'm just going to kind of show you the basics. This is the selection tool. If you click on that, it will give you all the different rotation and dragging sliders here. So this will scale things. This will drag it upon that axis. So this is the Y axis, this is the Z axis, and the X axis. These little handles will rotate upon those axes. So if I do this, you'll see it rotates that way. If I do this, it rotates this way. If I do this, it rotates this way. And I can drag things in those directions as well, right? Now, I'm going to go ahead and back that up because I just want to keep it straight up and down. This is your orbit tool, which just rotates around in an orbit. So this object is in the center, or really wherever you are, your camera is going to be in the center, and this is just going to rotate around that. So it's always going to have the same distance from your object when you're using this tool. And then this is kind of looks like a cross. It's your panning tool. If you're familiar with camera moves, a pan up or down, pan left or right, just means you're staying on that same plane relative to your objects. So you're not getting any closer or further away as far as your distance this way, but you may, you know, get further away left to right or up and down, that kind of thing. This is your dolly tool, and this will, it's like a dolly. It's going to zoom in or zoom out as though you're on a dolly track. So let's put it about right there, and let's grab this thing, maybe move it about here, and I'm actually going to straighten this up just a little bit more, because I find that one of the limitations of Dimension is when you're putting on a graphic, a texture of your own, that it doesn't always put them on there straight. So it's easier if you just kind of align the camera to be looking straight on and then place the graphic on there. So to do that, you'll come over here to your scene, which will have your beverage can with condensation on it. There's a pull ring we don't care about, liquid that we probably don't need to mess with, but you can if you want to change that to a certain color of liquid or a certain preset that's in Dimension. And this is the can itself. Let's click on that, double click to open it. And here's the can material, which is just got a little bit of texture to it. You can probably see it better from my end than you can on yours. I bet it's not going to show up on YouTube. But there's a little bit of a bumpy texture to it to sort of simulate aluminum. And you'll click here under Actions on this place graphic on model. So click that. I've already got a couple things that I worked on. They're not actually for a Coke can, but they kind of work because they were sort of flavored the same way. And I separated it into two pieces. So they're PNG files, so there's going to be an overlay, and I'll show you why I did that so that I can show you the difference between some things you can do with these textures. Let's go ahead and increase these to the same size, and I'll bump this one up until it fills the space. 12.8 looks great. I'm going to take this one to 12.8 as well. Oh, hold on. Yes, you can. You're lying to me. 12.8. So now they're scaled to the same size, and they're fitting on each other like I want them to. That's great. Once you have all of your elements on here, if you want to change things, so mess with the shininess of these objects, this is what you do. You click on your graphic. So let's click on the blue background graphic. And you can mess with the opacity, which I don't really want to mess with, or the roughness or metallic nature of it. The roughness is going to be, the higher the roughness, the more matte the material, right? The lower the roughness, the more sheen or shiny it's going to be. And I think with an aluminum can, you know, you want to keep it somewhere probably in the 25% to 0%. Let's just do 0%. And then I'll click on this other graphic and I'll bump it all the way up to 100% and show you what that looks like. Now, if you need to, this is a preview, but it's not a great preview because it's not fully rendered out. But if you want to render it, a render preview, come over here to this button and you click it. And then you'll see your computer will start to go, oh, okay, put the pieces together. It'll be a little bit grainy at first and it'll kind of fill in the information as it goes. Now, it will stay this way until I click that off. So if I change anything, it's going to start all over again on the render preview. But so far, that looks pretty cool. And you can see there's this shine that's coming in nicely from our default lighting and over here. Of course, that would change if I changed the angle of the camera. So you're going to get less of a shine if I put it over here, for instance. We'll just see what that looks like. But as you can see, there's no shininess up to the top part because I took the roughness all the way to zero. So, or actually, roughness all the way to 100%. So that is a more of a matte finish at the top, which you probably wouldn't have on a Coke can, but I'm doing it just to show you what you can do with this stuff. It's pretty cool. So anyway, I'll turn that off so that we can do a couple other things quickly. I think it looked better over here. And I'm going to change this graphic to roughness, bring it back down to zero so that I do get that sheen back. I'm going to change this middle one and see what this metallic thing looks like, though. I want to see just how different that is. And let's just do a quick render preview and see. The middle is going to have more of a metallic sheen to it, so maybe that you've printed it on some sort of metallic foil versus like a normal print. You know, say if your substrate was paper or vinyl or something like that. Anyways, very different. Obviously mutes the colors quite a bit. The contrast goes up. The shiny spots are shinier. But could be cool depending on what you're doing. You know, maybe instead of a graphic here, you just have a color and it's like a foil metallic look and that's what you're going for. Let's just bring it down to zero and see what the difference is. I mean, I think that looks way better, but just so you guys know what this does, you can mess with that metallic setting too. Once you've kind of got an object in here, you can come in here and do a lot of other things. You can add all of these items and layer as many 3D objects in here as you want. If you were going to show like a line of Coke cans, you know, and you needed six, you could put all those out there and then just stagger them. And that's pretty cool. But for this, I'm going to put a little bit of splash out there. Like it's a, and let's turn this off so we're not using that. I'm going to move this guy over maybe here. And then let's rotate it so it's not blocking our can, the main image here. Maybe see if I can find a good spot for it here. I think that works fine. And let's see, maybe we orbit around a little bit. Something like that, and then back out so we can get all the splash. And then I'll pan down. So anyway, there's your splash. It added that into the scene here. If you want to change the contents of the splash, you can double click on it. And what's cool is they've got some presets over here. So if you want water, you can click and drag water over here to splash material, and it will change it to water. Let's just do a beer. That's their preset beer texture. And so as you can see, it changed the color, but it really looks different once you render it out. And I'll show you what that looks like in just a bit. And then you can come in here and change lighting settings. We're not going to mess with that, but just know that if you know what a three-point lighting setting is, then that will add that for you. This is if you're going to be out in the sun. Various studio lighting settings are in here and as default. And I believe you can even customize those some. But again, we're doing the quickie here. What I'll probably do is just drop in an image like this table into the background. Now, obviously, that's floating and midair doesn't look very good, so we'll have to come around here and maybe rotate this a little bit so it actually looks like it's on the table, and then maybe pan this down so that it's probably about there. I may rotate that just a little bit more. No, I think that looks good. I think that'll look fine. And let's just go ahead and go over to render, and I'll show you what you can do. Here you can title it, let's just call it Coke Can, even though it's got beer in it. And then quality, I like it on high, and PSD or PNG, you can tell it where you want it to save it here. But if you want to do just the PNG, you can click that. That's going to be faster, and it can have a transparent background if you need it to. But if you do PSD, it's pretty cool. It'll render it out. Like so, kind of give you an estimate of how long it's going to take, probably a couple minutes, something like that. But you can already start to see it take shape. It's a little grainy at first, and then it will kind of, as it does a few more passes, it will clear a lot of this up, and it'll look a lot better when it's done. And while that's working, I'll show you one that I've already done. That was one I did previously. And here's one that I did for another client. This one is actual artwork I'm working on for a client. And I'm trying to show them mock-ups of what this will look like in real space. So I use these food pouches with these tear-off tops and a zipper right here to seal in like a matte black. And then I added the graphics that I made and added a shininess to them. So roughness was 0% on these, 100% on the material on the back here. And they look pretty cool. And of course, I did three of these. And the neat thing about having these in a PSD is that you get all this additional layer information, like these material selections, object selections, and depth information that you can look at if you need to. This just kind of looks like this. But gives you a lot of information with which to make selections if you need to, if you're going to make any alterations post-rendering. It also gives you just a regular render and a render with reduced noise. I don't know why it gives you both. Reduced noise looks better. If the background was white like it was in this one, it will just give you this. And you can hide that if you want to make this a transparent background. Or you can double click on here, change the color. You know, say we want to go with the yellow. Or you can double click on the layer itself and add gradients to it. Or, you know, whatever, textures and all sorts of stuff. So it's really, really cool. To have that kind of flexibility. And let's go back and look, and it's almost done. You can see it's starting to look really cool. And you can do that in like a minute and send it to your client, or save this in a brochure of some sort, because how hard is it to get this kind of an image, you know, of a can like splashing through actual liquid? Well, that's really difficult. You're gonna have to hire a photographer to get that done. But you could just throw it together in a couple minutes and include this in a brochure or flyer for your client and help them announce their new product that's about to come out, say in a week or something like that. Anyway, that's the gist of the tutorial. Let me know what you guys think of that. Leave a comment down below, like, subscribe, do all that jazz, and I will see you guys in the next video.